afternoon. My name's Ann Forshner, and I work for Banff, Yoho, Kootenay National Parks, studying species at risk. I'm on the second day of a 9-day trip into the backcountry to study species at risk. And along the way, we're going to look at some ways that we monitor populations of wolverine, a species at risk that is listed as special concern in Banff, Yoho, and Kootenay. Ecological connectivity ensures species can move freely and interact with one another in space. It's essential for conserving biodiversity. Parks Canada has recognized the importance of ecological connectivity and is working with partners to ensure we have good connectivity between Parks Canada places and surrounding areas. There's a number of different ways we can monitor wolverine populations, and one of them is using remote cameras. Now, we have a series of remote cameras that are part of the Ecological Integrity Monitoring Program in some of the mountain national parks, and what we've learned is that populations have declined about 40% over the last 10 years, but that we have three times the wolverine density inside of these areas, in Banff, Yoho, and Kootenay, as outside these areas. So the protected areas are really important for the wolverine populations, and there's things that we can do. This one is, you'll see, is set up facing some of the trails. This is a great location to pick up wildlife that might be moving through the area, wolverine and other species as well. One of the things that we found with our wolverine research was that wolverines avoid very low levels of human use, and they also avoid development. 95% of all of our wolverine locations occurred when there were three or fewer user groups in a 2-week period. So it's really important to have wide open spaces such as this where wolverines can go about their lives and continue to move throughout their territories. These areas are also really important for connectivity of wolverine populations. Now, the second method that we use to monitor wolverine populations is called run poles. And what we did was we set up a series of run poles throughout Banff, Yoho, Kootenay in the winter time. And at those areas, we were able to collect hair from wolverine in a non-invasive manner. And then using that hair, we're able to look at DNA and identify individuals. We're able to identify males and females. And we're able to, perhaps most importantly, assess connectivity, or whether or not wolverine from certain areas are able to move throughout their home ranges and also into adjacent home ranges or places that they live to have a connected population.